Heyo, everybody. XCI here for Let's Play of Dragon Age Origins. Here we have Xander, we have Ogryn, we have Liliana, and we have Shale. We are in Orzammar. I've done a couple things for cleanup. I haven't done any runs yet in the tunnels. I did change his armor. I put the Legion armor on Ogryn. I put the Dragon armor back on Alistair. I basically just went here. Let's just show you guys here. Alistair got the Dragon armor back. I believe I gave Sten the Ageless, maybe? I kept him with the better sword with all the buffs on it, because I do like Ogryn better. I like Ogryn better than Sten from a personality perspective. I think he's more in line with the Xander, but also his strength is really high right now. Like, I like his stats better. Anyways, I think he's maxed out his two-handed weapon tier or bucket, you know? I'm going to keep Ogryn on the team. I would prefer to have an Alistair back, but right now I'm going to keep it as is. I brought Liliana along because I'm going to do a run of the tunnels, but just in case there's a conversation start or whatever, I want to be recording just so I can cut around, you know, the slower
so
stuff.
I'm led
but
to
I want
understand
this.
That the sister is a follower of this Maker.
Am I the sister? Oh, that's so cute. It's like you're my big brother. Or sister. Or whatever.
I am a creature of stone. I rather doubt that we would be related in any shape or form.
Oh, I didn't mean literally. Don't you think that people can be related in spirit?
I notice that humans tend to believe in a great number of things that are not true.
So do dwarves.
Even when given evidence to the contrary.
So do dwarves.
Believing in things when there is no proof is what faith is all about, Shale.
Believing in things when there is no proof is what gullibility is all about.
Thank you, Shale.
So I am gullible now.
I take it we are no longer sisters in spirit.
Shale says things that other people don't. That's what's important. Is someone going to clean this up? Seriously, where's the maintenance crew? Anyways, I wanted to do one round over here on the bridge because I knew I could trigger something. I do know, and this is why I started recording, I do know that there is a trigger that happens in one of the first crawls, which is also, I just want to catch that one before I keep pushing deeper into the tunnels to do a grind for the treasure I left behind. How much money? I'll show you guys. So I got 91 gold now. I've cleared out my packs. I'm still pretty high because I want to do a round at Soldier's Peak and just, like, you know, I got to give things away. I got gifts, tons of gifts. I got to get rid of stuff like that. I like to sell certain things to the either to the Soldier's Peak guy or to, I think I've cleared a Duke and Thag. I want to go Carradine's Cross. I like to drop things either at the Soldier's Peak guy or at the dwarf at camp, so that if I ever want to buy it back, things like salves, things like that, I put them there. So it's an easy crawl. It's like easy for me to go back and grab that stuff if I regret it. Same things with certain named items. I'll do that too. There's a Soldier's Peak chest. See, I know there's something here. Wait for it. Right? No? No. Okay, so I'll be right back. I'm going to do a quick run, or I'll try to make it. I'm as quick as I can go. Why didn't I put... That's dumb. I should have had Win on here for Hasting. Well, I'll be right back. This is a really crappy map to navigate. I'll just give you a quick update. Did this cycle right here, did this one, and I'm doing this now, but then I got it back up again. Do this one, back up, do this one. This is a crappy, or do this one and then come up this way. It's a crappy map. I'll be back. I'm now going through the final tunnel here, and I do have this thing that I should record right there. I've got the Drifter's Cache. I don't know what that's going to trigger, but just in case it triggers something, I might as well start capturing dialogue now. Just in case there's something else that spawns around it, etc., etc. Packs are filling up. There it is. Oh, it actually says Drifter's Cache on the left. What's going on here? I have to... Oh, I thought this was a dead end. Oh, I thought it was a dead end. Did I not? I saw this though, right? I've been here. Because then I was... Oh, yeah. I looked at that water and I thought it was cool. Okay, maybe. I don't know. Let's see. What do we have? We have a large flawless... Ooh, flawless. Wait, I need flawless? There's another name, right? Doesn't matter. I'll check that after. Ring of the Warrior. We have +2 strength and dexterity. That's amazing. That's a great ring. We have efforts gloves. Didn't I have some other efforts armor or something? Massive gloves. All right, plus one strength, and then that's standard, and then Thorn of the Dead God. We have a one-handed dagger. That's maybe a Zevran blade right there. Plus 3 damage, plus 3 armor penetration. Take all. I have room. Thorn of the Dead Gods. I see. What exactly did that do? The Drifter's Cache. Crosscut Drifter's Cache. Keratin's Cross has been uncovered. Okay. Items. There we go. Ooh, look at all the stuff I missed. Under items. Oh my gosh. I can't even begin to figure out where these are located. What I've missed so far. Oops. Let's see. Thorn of the Dead Gods. In the moment that it struck, the blade of the Grey Warden who killed Toth, Archdemon of Fire, shattered into 3 pieces. After the Battle of Hunterfell, the Wardens carried their fallen brother to Weishaupt for a hero's burial, but the broken pieces of his sword were left behind. For years, the shards lay forgotten on the battlefield. Steel became etched with the corrupted blood of the dead god. They were eventually discovered by a Navarran woman searching among the bones for a sign of her lost son. She sold them to a blacksmith, not knowing what they truly were, for 10 bits. Good deal. The smith, however, knew that he had purchased more than scrap metal and fashioned the shards into 3 identical daggers. Interesting. The Thorns of the Dead Gods. Can you find these other 2 somewhere in the world? There's like 3 of them here or something? I don't know. They left his hands and were scattered to the far corners of Thedas, but everywhere they went, the thorns left misery and loss in their wake. The woman who unearthed them died soon after of plague. The smith fell into his forge. Jesus, each person who has held one of the thorns, even briefly, has died an untimely death. Well, it looks like I got death in my future, whether I wield it or not, because I just came into contact with it. That's awkward. Anyways, let's keep going. Ooh, I should actually go and talk to Ruck again. He's in there, right? I think. Am I in the wrong place? What is this, actually? Oh, the thing. Oh, wow, I totally forgot about this. Where's Ruck? Right here? Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna talk to him, see if the mother came looking for him. That would be crappy. An admirable topsider, because I got all the blade pieces. Oh, so this actually used to come. I thought this was going to be like a filler episode. No, there's some stuff going on. It's cool. We have quest completed here. The topsider's sword has been reconstructed after returning the pieces to his remains. And then we have codex updated. Topsider's honor. Let's read the last one here. There must always be another to take up arms against the darkness. That is the core of true family beyond kin and the unifying link that will bring day to night and allow the fallen to rest. Restored inscription. Trailmont family blade. There you go. Alright, so there's a dwarf buried amongst... There's an elf buried amongst dwarven history. Buried in dwarven history, not buried amongst dwarves, because there's not many dwarves buried here. It's a sarcophagus in the middle of nowhere. Surrounded by incursion after incursion of darkspawn. So, I guess that's some sort of respect, though he's buried with the Legionnaires, which I believe that... Ooh, what's this? Engraved silver bolt, just an art object, which I guess that's who he fought alongside. He didn't really go up to Orzammar and blah, blah, blah with the dwarves. He fought along those who were basically... who left society to be fighting dead men. Anyways, next thing, Ruck. I'm really hoping that Ruck's mother did not come after him. And like there's something like he kills her because he's gone crazy, you know? Does the game even know that I've lied? Let's find out.
Good friend is back.
I'm a good friend.
Won't make Ruck remember the light. How can Ruck help the friend?
I never talked to your mother. Do you have anything for trade? I have a few questions for you, Ruck. I should go. I just realized I could have just come back to Ruck and sold things. Nah, let's sell things now. Oh, I actually got the blade after I restored it. Ooh, and it's like an elven blade. I might put this on Xander. 31 strength. I need one more strength. I mean, I don't really make use of it, but it'd be cool. Just to put it on Xander. There is something called effort. Here's the armor for it. Effort right here. We have Effort's gloves. It's a massive armor. Ooh, I kind of want to know what this turns. Ooh, look, because that's crazy. Plus 15 to healing effects received. 38. That's pretty good. I don't know where to get the rest, but I'm very tempted. I don't know if I want you guys to ruin it for me or not at this point, but I'm very tempted. There we go, and I just gave Ogryn the Ring of the Warrior. Makes sense that he'd get it. Buff him up some more, because why not? Why not make him more deadly? There we go. So nothing really broke here by telling the mom. I mean, I don't have to tell him that I told her. So, you know what? Let's raise Liliana while we're here. I will do Cunning, I think. I've noticed a lot of bard abilities and stuff like that need Cunning. So let's just start cranking that up a little bit. Let's get her... I don't know why I ended up... Maybe she already started with this. I don't know. I feel like everyone should just get... Screw stealing too. Not useful. Next playthrough, I'm just going to put everybody into herbalism. So no matter who I have, I always have someone who can craft, at least bare minimum, the lesser potions, you know? Maybe the normal ones, but the lesser at least. So let's get her going on that track. And then for her power, let's probably do Lacerate, backstab damage. The assassin's foe is riddled with bleeding wounds. Yeah, I like her going down the assassin path. I think that makes some pretty good sense, too. Hank, she's right beside Zevran at the campfire. So he's probably convinced her. He's trained her, convinced her that it's the proper way of life. And didn't I harden her, or whatever you guys said, whatever that's called? So yeah, I like it. Oh, and I forgot to tell you guys. I also leveled Ogryn a while back, and I gave him Champion. I love Champion, and I like the idea that Xander's kind of influenced that direction in people. So, there you go. There's the update. Ooh, I guess I have another opportunity to talk to the Legionnaires, too. I keep calling No, Legionnaires. What's his name? Cardal. I get to talk to Cardal again. That's cool. Let me do a quick run to this side to see if there's anything locked. I guess it would have popped up by now, right? With my tab. No? So let's talk to Cardal real quick, just to see if he says anything now that all the things are done.
If I'd heard it secondhand, I'd have called it a sodding lie. Warden, we've got a king because of you. The rest, impressive. But the Legion is grateful most for restored leadership. It frees us to fight to the Darkspawn properly.
I'm happy to have come back here. There's a lot of reasons why you should do a second sweep of things you clear in the game. You'd be missing these plot points. Can I count on you to fight the Blight at my side? Ooh, that'd be awesome, actually. And then I could, make an agreement that I'd bring wardens down here. I'm glad Frelda needs you at your best. Orzammar's lucky to have you. I want to just straight up ask.
Nay, our place is down here. When you break the Blight, and you've got the skill, we'll make sure they have nowhere to retreat. You'll have us indirectly.
Ooh,
that's more than any sorcerer can say.
Yeah, that's cool. Persuade. We need you topside. Oh, show the world your skill. Oh, I can persuade into this? I'm gonna try.
You alone have the skill to back up your words. Each of the Legion owes our homeland a death, but if our lives are better shed on the surface, so be it. Back to Orzammar when we win, though. I'll not stay topside to lose my stone sense.
Well, that was awesome. I didn't know you could do that. That's awesome. Yes. I got the Walking Dead behind me. Yes. At my side. At our army side. What does that do for, the end? Do I have, a Dark Legion? God damn it. What are they called again? The Dead? Oh, God. The Legion of the Dead? Do I have a Legion of the Dead, in camp? And, oof. That's sweet. Alright, this trap here keeps on resetting. And it's about time I disable this. There it is. So how do I... Where's the disable point? As soon as I step over it, it's going to trigger, but I can't disable it. Whatever. I don't know if that's a bug or what the hell. A runestone? How'd I forget a runestone?
As you like.
Damn it. What do we have? We have a codex. Ooh, this thing. Let's go to the last one, hopefully. Let's see, we have... Let's just start reading and see. So we have towers. They name it a blight, the third by their reckoning. It was just the fight to our ancestors continued, even though it shifts settings. The hordes that press their borders surge and release, spilling across the surface. They fortify and follow. It was not their way to let the enemy rest. The surface kingdoms declare victory. The horde is crushed, the push halted, and celebrations begin as humans thank the skies and their maker beneath their gaze and their feet. The darkspawn retreat to the steps of our thags. New front lines are drawn across old. They settle in to breathe, the memories say, as happened twice before and likely in the darkness before that. Yeah, so this is the whole thing that the surface only cares when it's up there, you know? I think I actually read that last one. It might be this one we didn't read, which is the surface declares the fourth blight, a number that means nothing to the stone. In the depths, the events are inverted, our blight spanning the interim years. Seven generations of shifting lines in darkness. Our ancestors are the reasons the surface kingdoms don't know a darkspawn by sight. Why even their eldest have never heard an accounting firsthand. That's true. They believe the blights are defeated by a gathering of allies with singular focus. Eventually, they will be lost by attrition in the depths. That's fun. Yeah, I wish that could get, like, fixed, you know? Like, some sort of, there's an alliance that you can form that just helps fix this. This is a fixable problem. It's kind of nasty because it looks like the Earth itself is living. Like, it's got flesh everywhere. God, that was a disgusting fight. I mean, not difficult. Disgusting. Last board. To you guys, this will be cut up nice and short. I'm, just let you know, time on my side. I've been doing this for 45 minutes. I've been running around for 45 minutes. Some stuff, I mean, you know, I think... The completest part of a player has to do this. Not just for the treasure. I mean, I wouldn't have gotten... Oh, wait. I wouldn't have gotten that Legionnaire thing. I'm curious, like, where that other female, that female dwarf went off to. Like, I feel like they should have put that somewhere. They've resolved that somehow. And it gives you the opportunity to do a second sweep for codexes that you might have missed, which I did. I missed that one. Well, it wasn't a new entry, but it was an update of an entry. So I was able to get that again. And here we are at the final battleground, and I think I'm done. Sweep over. Oh, right. Oh, my God. I think the way to get out of here, I might have to go the long way. Here we go. Crossing fingers. Oh no, I gotta run it all the way back. Oh, that should not be. Damn it. Catch you on the flip side. Oh, thank God that's over. Can I go straight up to, I can indeed. All right, so let's do this. I'm gonna trigger something just in case. Ooh, I gotta go after the dragon. Where is it? I get right here. Oh my God, I can't believe I just clicked on that without even thinking. I need to maybe hit the campsite? Yeah. Maybe I do the dragon this episode. Hopefully this doesn't end up too long. I can shorten it and put the dragon at the tail end or something. I do want to do this just in case something triggers in camp, and it didn't. So good, I can cut around this too. There we go. Now let's do a run of... Let's see what the dwarf is. Oh, where's Ogryn at? By the food. By the food, where I'm assuming is also where the booze is at. Emissary. Here, let's talk to him. I want to see if he's...
Orzammar has sent her best warden. He's a Legion guy, it has though. Been a long time since the dwarven army has marched on the surface.
Do you need anything? Keep them at the ready. You're sure you haven't forgotten how? Do you... What, fight on the surface?
We'll be fine, as long as the ground hasn't forgotten how to shake.
Thank God you took that as a joke, because it could have been taken wrong.
At your command, Warden. Orzammar's finest are eager to carve some history.
Okay, let's
outfitting any army on short notice, there's always room for more gear.
Okay, so
gems would serve the most utility. The middle stones, sapphires and the like. We're dealing with many smaller foundries and larger values might overwhelm.
I've been selling gems.
At your command,
I need to go search for gems.
Orzammar's finest are eager to carve some history.
You're sure they are? You're sure they're up to it?
We'll be fine, as long as the ground hasn't forgotten how to shake.
Okay, so let's hit these. Let's do this.
Very well.
Let's do gems for dwarves. I don't think I sold this round. I totally forgot actually right now. So, so three types. I need to write these down. I'm recording anyway, so I'll write these down. So sapphires, malachites, topazes. I don't care. All of them. I don't know how many I have. I'm just gonna keep going. It's either money or it's. Screw it. Ooh, now I got a ton of money. I might give a bunch of more money to the humans. I wish this would tell you your gauge. Like, you could have a gauge to this. When do you stop? When do you stop giving? I don't need death roots. I think, right? And then deep mushrooms are for injury kits. I also don't care for. I'm not doing the Alfreds, though. I could always go back and get more if I need, but I'm not going to do that. And then we're going to do the circle. I think I have novice runes. Sir, I don't care. Let's do... I should probably have looked before I've done that. I did that, though. I like the damage ones, you know? Okay, maybe I won't do that anymore. Okay, then the human. Let's do... Jesus, 30 gold, huh? That's how much I gave the first time and I, like, destroyed my coffers. I don't know, you guys let me know. Like, I think I gave 30 the first time, so I don't know if I should give another 30. Like, what's the benefit? I don't want you guys to spoil anything, because I don't know what this means. But, like, is there a way for me to know the cap? Is there a way for me to know when I've given as much as I can benefit from?
We are better with every step you take.
That's kind of what I'm looking for. Let me do a round
of talking
here.
Of Magi stands ready to assist, Grey Warden, as do the Templars of the Chantry.
They will work together? Did I not get this before? Because that sounds weird.
The sincerity of your cause has drawn them together under a common banner.
I don't know if I missed that.
It would not have
what?
Happened
it's been a while.
Otherwise.
Well, you're welcome.
At your word, Warden.
What do you got? Your men will commit to my cause?
I would not insult them by asking. Word was given, and that is all that needs be said.
Do you need more elf root? And then we have Lieutenant.
On your order, Grey Warden.
What do you got? This will be different from guarding the Arl.
We are aware. But these men and women know what to
stake. I don't know how to tell.
They will not fail their
home. I'm gonna move on. I can't be stuck on this. I gotta move on. I do feel like I want to kill a dragon by the end of this episode. So that it's not just a big... I really want to talk to Morgan again to see what's going on there. Just so it doesn't feel like it's just a grind, like a filler episode. So here's... I'm gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna go to Soldier's Peak real quick. But I'm gonna gather the party that I would take to kill a dragon if I so chose. Oh man, I feel like it has to be Shell.
Yes.
I think this is my solid group because he can wipe out weird things that happen. But I feel like I changed his gear around and I should look at what sword he has again before I commit to anything. I'm gonna go to Soldier's Peak first and then I'm going to hit the dragon up. I'm going to do it. Yeah, I'm going to do it. I don't know how long this is going to be. I'm now crawling past an hour. I hope this thing doesn't crash. This is because my software has crashed before. I'm hoping it doesn't crash. Oh, and the reason why I come here, just in case you guys are wondering, is because I like these named things. I don't like to sell them. I don't know. I feel like I shouldn't. I think I might have filled my chest. I can't actually put any more items in it. Look. Well, damn. That's going to take some time to fix now. Ooh, the Topsider Blade or Merrick's Blade? Merrick's Blade. Has that versus Darkspawn thing that doesn't work. Weakens nearby Darkspawn, which probably doesn't work. The regen stuff is okay. I mean, it's just more damage on the other one. I don't use the blade anyways, so I think I'm going to move those runes into the Topsider Blade. And I'm going to switch the sword on Xander. Yeah. Guys, I just noticed something. I was running between these vendors Am I just imagining things? Okay, maybe I'm imagining things. No, I'm not. This bird is following Shale. The bird is following Shale. I was having a chuckle because I was like, wouldn't it be funny if that's what was going on? And every time I came out of the vendor, there'd be a bird by Shale.
Warden.
Anyways, I'm checking to see who's got the gems. I'm just doing recon right now. Because I know I sold that other guy has some, but now I've already forgotten what I didn't write it down. I haven't ended the episode yet. I'll write it down, and then I'll come in for the... I gotta do a run for the gems, but see? Okay, that's pretty amusing. I mean... pointless, but amusing. Also, I need to change characters around before I do the dragon. I just realized that the Ogryn has the rings, the ring and the key. No, I have the Xander has the key. Ogryn has the +2 strength, +2 constitution. I need to put that on Alistair. I need to put his other ring on Alistair too. Here, let's switch this up. Sorry, because he's got two good things. Well, dexterity is a whatever, but Alistair's is an even more whatever. Fire resistance and dexterity. Ooh, fire resistance would be good. Let's take that off you. That's an ogre item anyways. Let me see what sword he has. It doesn't matter. It's two-handed. Doesn't matter. And then we have... let's just check Liliana's stuff. Cunning and cunning. Hostility. Healing. Wind is coming with us. Cold resistance, that's gonna get replaced. I need fire resistance for this fight, so let's set this up. We have this on Xander, on Alistair. What does he have? Defense. Yeah, but he's got great defense and spell resistance. I don't think dragons do that though. I'm gonna do fire. Do fire resistance there. Shale should be protected against fire. She's doing fire damage. That's gotta go. That's gotta change the cold, probably. But she doesn't have a big... she does. Oh, maybe. Wait, what's this one? Oh, well, it's not as good, but it's still better. Yeah, she's gonna have to switch to cold. And her armor's gonna have to switch to fire. Fire, yeah. 30% fire resistance. There we go. I need to be doing cold damage... if I could get another cold damage rune on here, I'm going to do that next. Here we go. Gotta go prepared. I don't know what to expect. Oops, nope. There we go. This guy. Sandal. Sword. Duncan's blade can take the frost rune. +3. There we go. So we got +3. That's pretty solid. That's pretty solid. And there's that squeaking, that friggin' schmooples. Squeaking. Okay. I'm gonna hit the mountains. I have been recording for almost an hour and a half. It's an hour and 18 minutes.
Yes.
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 Let's do this. I mean, how long could this fight take? I'm sure I have a bunch of stuff I can cut around anyway, so it doesn't matter. Yeah, but I'm gonna have to run around this entire temple to get to this dragon. I'll cut this into 2 episodes, I suppose, if I have to. Every time I say a statement like that, I have to cut around it, because... why would I keep it in? Oh, random encounter. So, it doesn't... this is going to throw things off now.
There!
Because now this is going to kill the episode. I'm not going to be able to do it. Shoot, I should have just ended it. I should end it here and continue it and do the dragon fight in a new episode. I'm going to commit. There's a lot of Genlocks and crap going on here, though. Sure, let's just go.
More of the fiends ahead!
Yeah. You know what? Everybody just... hold on, let's zoom this up. I'm gonna go right into the center of this. Why are you still standing there, Shale? Did I not? I didn't highlight you, huh? Here, let's do it this way. There we go. Zoom in here. Shale to get in position. And let's buff people up. Sure, I don't think there's a yet. Oh, what's this guy? Ogre. Okay, that's the guy. That's the guy for Xander. I don't know why I don't have any of these open to me. I got all my stamina. Oh, well. And Alistair... I think I'm going to keep Alistair here for a sec. Until that ogre gets nearby. Why is Xander... I'm a little bit confused. I guess I'll debuff people while I'm here. I will rush this guy with Alistair. Here, get into flank there, Alistair. There we go. And then, I can't knock this guy down, but I can sure as hell mess him up. He's dead. There we go. Here, help. Help this guy out. Why not? And then, let's go over here. Xander's gonna push the guy back. There we go. Give Alistair a chance to get in here. There we go. Let's go for some range, guys.
I must maintain.
And this guy.
It is begun.
Kill shot. Very well. We overkill here, but man. There we go. Oh, a knight's corpse. Sorry, knight. I tried to save as many as I could. Is there someone I can talk to get some context behind what just went down? I should also probably... That doesn't matter. I'm leaving the board anyways. I'll take some Malfruit. Sure. That's not what I intended. There we go. Ooh, this night. Oh, I forgot to redo potions. That doesn't matter. I got Wind with me right now if I need to. I'm at 39. I guess I don't need to. I got plenty. Oh, it's like one of those things I did with the mage where we ended up on a board where the mages were kind of prepping some people for combat. So I guess we get
very well.
We get an encounter for each of the units that we got. Is that what's going on? The closer we get, here, let's talk to one guy.
Our Leman sends his regards, Warden. We're trying to keep the roads clear and safe.
All right. Are you guys saying
our
the
Leman
same thing?
Sends his regards, Warden. We're trying to keep the roads clear and. Our Leman sends his regards, Warden. We're trying to keep the roads.
Now, if only I could get straight up to the mountain and not have to run this, but this episode's gonna take me the longest to cut through. It's gonna be so much editing. This would be the perfect time to take salves as well. I'm gonna assume this is harder than Flemeth. What's technically the hardest one? Because I've leveled a couple times now and I've got better armor, right? But in theory, what's better? Which of these is actually tougher? The Flemeth or this one? Because I don't know how to judge that, because the game, I believe, scales things. So I should probably figure out... I should probably do this right now, actually. Warmfell increases the user's resistance to fire. So let's put it over here. And let's do that. I only have two. So it's going to be, I think, Xander and Alistair need to turn that on. I don't think it does anything else. Like, does it shoot electricity out of its mouth or anything like that? I wonder if it does. I don't actually know. I think I sold everything else. That's all the other stuff that was like, that would buff things. Got rid of it all. So now it's pretty much, there we go, screw it. We have some bombs. Where are you, dragon? Oh shit, the horn. I forgot the horn. Can I just shoot it? I should have saved it. I don't know if it auto-saved, but like, I don't know if I screw something up by not using the horn to do this. Is the horn a quest item? Am I incorrect here? Like, do I... The hell, I made this sword. Why are these three pieces here? Hold on, let me just do a quick... Because what if there's a movie? You know what I mean? For the horn? Oh, no. I don't know if I'm going to ruin a cinematic, like I've missed a cinematic now or not. But here's the thing. I thought that Colgrim's horn was a plot item. Wouldn't it be under plot items here? Like, you can't sell them or put them... And chests, like you can't get rid of them. I don't see Colgrim's horn here. I mean, I shot him, so who cares? Like, did I wipe it as soon as I shot the dragon? It, like, left the inventory? I don't remember if it's at Soldier's Peak or not. I'm not willing to go back and see at this point. I'm just going to do this. How bad could this be? I mean, Yeah, how bad could this be? I'm gonna use this thing. I'm gonna use this thing, and I'm gonna assume it's coming down after me. So I'm just gonna set this up and wait. Maybe here. Let's see if Xander can still shoot at him. Holy crap! Oh, okay. Hold on. It's right down on us. Wait, I'm losing a character. I've lost a character. Where is Shale? Where is Shale? Right now? Okay, well, maybe it's bugged and she'll come back. Oh my gosh, she landed on Shale. That's awesome. Okay, Alistair, you're up. You're gonna start healing Shale. I have a feeling she's stuck there. Yeah, for sure. She's gonna get ruined. You know what? I'm sort of okay with that. I do want Alistair to go behind. There we go, for a flank. Oh my god, I can't even zoom out far enough to know if I am flanking. I don't know, is that kind of a flank? There, maybe that's a flank. Now, I need to shield wall this. I don't think the dragon has anything cast on it. Like, I shouldn't, like, debuffing it's not gonna do shit. And then I'm gonna regen Shale. I don't know what Wynn was doing right there, but it doesn't matter. I'm gonna do that. I just have to keep her up. I'm going to life ward Shale as well. And Alistair, you're going to start pounding with the shield. Xander is going to... I should get closer and do a debuff with the shout. But I have a feeling I'm going to screw myself if I do that. So crit shot. Alistair, heal. Shale is not going to be good in this mode, I don't think. I could use Wynn to just keep charging her. And this could be a Xander-Alistair fight, I think. Man, I don't know. She's got to turn this on, maybe. Yeah, Shale's going down. If I keep her in this form, she's going to die. Okay, so I have to unhook her. Unhook her, get some health.
I'll kill it.
Health potions in her. And then I'm going to start going into... Holy crap, where did Alistair go? Oh my god, that's amazing. So killing blow is like that one attack where it's like all her stamina gets put into this. Which is... Screw it. Yep, so that's going to happen like that, and I think at this point I don't know what's around my head right now, probably some fear crap. I'm going to do this. I think this is a bad idea. I'm going to do this. I think it's a bad idea, but I'm going to debuff here. Alistair, where are you at, buddy? Oh my god, get back in the fight. Oh, Shale's on the ground. Okay, that's fine there. Shale, I don't think got the attack off, and I don't think I can afford to not heal her right now. Let's do that as well. Let's just watch this just in case.
Yeah.
There we go, Alistair back in it. She's going to get mangled right now, but that's fine, because now Alistair's going to start some crazy crap right here. There we go. Also, I could swear I made Alistair champion. Why don't I have... Oh, I see, I did, but I'm still working on... I did, that's right, shield wall. Okay, that's fine. And I think everyone's fine, unless this dragon is starting to go for Wynn. Maybe a backup Wynn a little bit more. I don't want to waste magic healing Wynn. Oh, shit. That was a lot, she just healed. That's okay. I'm going to punch the dragon. Yeah. Shield fist? Oh, she's the only one who got that in. Man, where's the health at? Oh, shit. I mean, I think I gotta do this with endurance. It's pretty much what this is coming down to. I need to spread the ranged folks out, because the dragon's gonna come for them now. Alistair, are you back? Yeah, that's the thing with being behind the dragon. You just get tail slapped all over the place. How'd you say? Oh, there it is. That's problematic. That's on a Wynn? No, that's on a Xander. Okay, so here. Preemptive regen on a Xander, and Xander is going to have to run it. He's going to have to run it over there.
I'm ready.
I need him to get away from Wynn. I need Xander to get away from Wynn right now. Wynn, how are you doing? Is it on you? I hope it's not. It is. It just stunned us. So, I can't get threatened on because it's disabled. That would be a good time for this. But unfortunately, I have no way to do that. Okay. This could be risky right now. This could be a bad sign.
Yeah.
If this stun doesn't go away, there we go, it's away. Let's start spreading them out again. I'm going to go further back with Xander. He's got some pretty damn good reach. So I'm going to go way back. I think I can't get Wind further away. I can, a little bit. But this is not... I'm not in a good place right now. I also need more stamina. And I just clicked off my screen. Oh my god. Okay. At least it wasn't a crash. At least it wasn't a crash. Let's punch her.
Fine.
Punch her. Yeah. Punch. That dragon's a her, right? Oh no. Oh no, Alistair. I'm sorry for what's about to happen to you. That's far enough away, Xander. Let's start trying to aggro again.
Here.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that's doing some damage. That's doing some damage. Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. Does it ever drop them after it takes it into the mouth? Does he have... Oh my god. Okay. Okay. I can maybe get a peel off in time. You know what? Here, let's do one of these on him. I feel like that's actually been working pretty pleasantly. Shale, you're still doing your business. I wanna get... You know what? I'm gonna get her back into this form. I'm gonna try to heal her up as much as I can. I'm gonna go back in that form. Good, Alistair. Good for you. Xander is hopefully gonna pull some aggro here. I'm gonna try to... I think this somehow pulls aggro. Scattershot? We'll find out. We will find out. Okay, both these people to drink their potions. Shale didn't get the potion off in time. Damn, man. And I think Shale is... Yep. I think I might have bugged out. Am I in a... Oh, she can run on this stuff. I thought I was stuck. Like I was on the edge of a board there. I didn't know that I could do that. Okay, so... Sure. I guess I'm fine. I think. I hope. Shale is still drinking. Alistair... Oh, boy.
I shall do so.
Let's see what happens. There we go. Okay, Shale got it off. Alistair is still good. I don't know what this green thing is, if that's a good or a bad thing. Oh, it's the life ward? Is that what that is? Well, it's good that he still has that warmth, that thing on. The balm. Okay, you set that off. That dragon doing a liftoff is probably going to come at Xander. Let me just recycle. I need to cycle through this. Yeah, drink that. Okay, good. Right? Yeah, see? That thing pulls aggro. That's the power. That power's been messing me up. Oh well, so now Xander's going to have to dodge stuff for a while. I'm going to run it now, just so I don't make these guys have to run for the dragon. There we go. Yeah, I'll take it. There we go. Let's run it to here, I guess. Let's keep him running. I need to get her mana back up. This might be the time to use one of these big ones, even though she doesn't really have a lot of bar there, but it's necessary. Otherwise, I'm going to start losing people. This has become an endurance fight for sure. Maybe I go into this mode real quick for Alistair's sake. Let's see if I can get something off here.
Take that!
Oh, just kick in the face. That was regen. Regen Shale.
Ready.
Sure, I'll do one of these. I don't think I can paralyze. I can't paralyze a dragon. Man. Here, let's start reducing the armor. Oh, it's coming for Xander. You know what? Maybe I take the focus off the other guys for a while. Yeah, I think that... Oh my god, what a run this is going to be, though. Sure, small potion in.
All right.
You are going to run, though, right? No, just... But run. Okay, and then she's stunned, which... Oh no, she's in the form, so it doesn't matter if she's stunned or not. Xander, you need to get back in the blue if you're going to be this courageous. Nope, I can't get past the dragon. And it's going to stun me. Nope. Nope. Nope, that's fine. That's fine. Let's go. Let's go in here. There we go. Alistair, how are you doing there, buddy? Shit, crippling shot. This is a long fight. It's at half. I'm still feeling good. I feel like I have a good handle on things. Her magic is gone again, though. That's crazy. Phew. Alright, well, when you get up, Alistair, drink that back, because if I lose you, I'm in trouble. There we go. There we go. And now we got a good flank going on, so let's start with your attacks here. Everyone being Surrounding a dragon like this is no good, though. It's no good. It's no good. So let's move Xander. Yeah, but I'm in the blue. I want to be in the blue still. Let's go over here.
Yes!
Oh, she's on... Okay, that's fine. That's fine. That's fine. I really don't want to lose Shale. Here, Life Warder. First. Oh, God. And then Healer. There we go. Right. Do it. Yep, good. Armor is good. Sure, let's do this, even though it doesn't work. Shale is going to stay in that mode, but I do need... Did I heal her? Because I feel like nothing happened here. Oh, she's stunned. Shit. Uh-oh. I'm starting to get a little disoriented. I'm getting a little disoriented.
You need help?
How are you doing there, Xander? I don't know. Debuff, maybe? Maybe this works. Resisted. Oh, no. She's dead. Yeah, she's gonna die. Oh, God. Let's see if I can pull this off here. Oh. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. If she goes down, I'm dead. Yep, she's stunned. Well, if I lose Shale, I can try to revive her. This is gonna be bad. It's gonna be so close. There, we got her. We got her back. Let's heal her. Okay, we got it at quarter. It's at quarter. I'm gonna try to cripple it some more. Oh, there we go. Got the aggro back, which is fine. I'm fine with that. Let's do a light potion. Let's just fill up on light potions just to make sure everyone is sound.
Immediately.
And I don't want Wynn wasting that her mana on healing herself. Yep, that was bound to happen. I saw them coming from the rear, and the AI immediately tail whips. Son of a bitch. Okay, change modes. And drink another one back. And then go over here. And then Alistair. Yep, you're good. You're set. And another mana potion. And put it back. Put it back, and I can stone fist it, or I can haze people. Let me do this again. Waves of healing and cleansing energy emanate from the caster nearby Alistair. 3 seconds injuries. Yeah, okay, so that's got to go back on. That's got to go back on. There we go. And I'm going to move in closer with Wynn, despite this being dangerous, but I need that healing. You're going to put one of those back. You're going to put one of those back. Xander's going to hold the aggro with this power right here. Because I think I can take this aggro for a while. I'm actually good. I'm going to defense it up. I think I got it. We're done. Oh, he's on the head. He's on the head. Oh, he's on the head. He's on the head. Oh. Oh. Ah. I almost missed it. I almost missed it. Yay, Dragon Slayer. Achievement unlocked. Immediately got a head rush. Yeah. Bye-bye, Hydro. Holy shit. There's that dragon scale you guys were saying. So this creates another piece of armor. Deadhead charge. It's okay. Physical resistance. Ooh, pure bitch braid. Look at that. +8, +8. Ooh, that's pretty good. Oh, a new kite shield. That's an Alistair thing, maybe. But it's like normal. What's this stuff? Oh, just heavy plate. Maybe it swallowed a knight. We got Canary Siege Gauntlets. Maybe I'll switch. Nah, it looks like crappy tier 4 stuff. +20% electricity damage on a mage. Morgan does not have lightning. I don't think I put that on her. Did I? I don't remember. But that's pretty good if it's a mage thing. And then we have the Long Sight. +5% ranged critical chance. Ooh, I like that. Light helm and it's Drake skin. That's going on Xander. And Teven longbow. I'll give that to Zevran. Crow dagger. Another crow dagger. Holy smokes. And look how much I cleared my packs. Gobble, gobble. There we go. There's the dragon scale quest. You found dragon scale. Perhaps a master armor smith could do something with it. So back to Wade we go. And that's it. That. What the hell? Did I not... Did I just miss this before? Are these things locked? Do I have to bring Liliana back? I totally forgot these things. So. I didn't even know these were here. An art object. I just got one of those already. Oh, I gotta bring Liliana back. Anyways, holy crap. That was a pretty good haul. And it was good XP too, man. I think I got pretty decent, a pretty good... Yeah, I'm gonna have to come back with Liliana. Anyways, This is going to be an editing nightmare. I'm at an hour and 45, just so you guys basically get a gauge of how much I have to edit this episode down, how much filler there is. This fight was actually way longer than I thought. I think this was, a 20-minute fight or something? Anyways, don't forget to explore, engage, and inspire, folks. Catch you around. Peace, everybody. Yeah. Dragon Slayer. That's right.